Hello everybody, 大家好, welcome to Mr. Cho's Chinese class. In today's video, we're going to continue to talk about lesson 18, the sports unit. Let's get started. So in lesson 18, we talked about how Gao Wenzhong 不喜欢做运动, 他不喜欢做运动。 Gao Wenzhong 有两年没做运动了。 So here is one of the grammar points we talked about yesterday, which is hasn't been doing something for however long. 两年没做运动。他现在越来越胖了。 So 越来越胖 is another grammar point. 越来越 means more and more. So he's gaining more and more weight. 他怕累,不喜欢运动。 We also talked about 怕 yesterday. 怕 means to be afraid of something. So he doesn't want to get too tired, 所以他不喜欢运动。王鹏呢,他一直会找高文忠做运动。但是呢,高文忠每次都会说,no,no,no。那我们看一下高文忠他有哪些借口。借口 means excuses, 借口。一开始,王鹏找高文忠去跑步。跑步,王鹏说,我们去跑步吧。 跑步最简单 means simple. 高文忠说什么呢? 他说,冬天那么冷,夏天那么热,跑步太难受了。难受 means doesn't feel comfortable. We're going to talk about that later. So here, Wenzhong's expectation is like here, 我们去跑步吧,跑步很好。高文忠呢,他说,哎, 跑步太难受了。那我们来看一下里面的一些生词。第一个是简单和容易差不多。简单和容易差不多。我们学过容易，容易 means easy. 简单的意思是 simple. So in most of the cases, you can use 简单 and 容易 pretty much interchangeably. 你可以说这个问题很简单，你也可以说这个问题很容易。 Right, they pretty much means the same thing. 但是呢,有的时候简单和容易有一点点不一样。比方说,我这个人很简单,我这个人很简单。That means I'm a simple person, I'm a simple man. Okay, I'm not very complicated, but we don't really say 我很容易. That wouldn't make sense, right? Gao文忠讲到, 冬天很冷,夏天很热,所以我们来复习一下 the four seasons. 第一个是春天,春天是 spring, 第二个是夏天,夏天是 summer, 第三个是秋天,秋天是 fall, 最后一个是冬天,冬天是 winter. Okay, I think we learned that in the unit 11. 然后在后面呢,有一个生词是难受。难受 can mean physically uncomfortable or not feeling well. 难受,我很难受。你乱吃东西,肚子不舒服,很难受。So here, 难受 is kind of like 不舒服. It can also mean emotionally that you're feeling sad. 我心里觉得很难受,我考试是有考60分,所以我很难受。 我很难受. Okay, so you can say 难受,想哭. You're so sad that you want to cry. 难受,想哭. 所以呢,后来他们没有去跑步. 王鹏呢,想要找高文忠去打网球. 打网球. 王鹏说,你打网球吧. 高文忠说什么呢? 高文忠说,打网球,得买网球拍. 网球鞋,你知道,网球拍,网球鞋,贵极了,贵极了, extremely expensive. So 高文忠说,他不想去买这些东西,网球拍,网球鞋,太贵了。 我们看一下里面的生词,第一个是得,得, so this one, we need to pay a lot of attention, because we've learned previously as the, and now it's pronounced differently. When it's pronounced as day, it is a modal verb. It's kind of like used similarly like 应该. Day means that you have to, or you must, you ought to do something. So for day, usually you want to do an action A. But in order to do that, you have to do action B first. So in that case, you can use day. 你要做A,你得先做B。So in our lesson, the example is that 他们要打网球。And in order to do that, they have to get 网球拍,网球鞋, a tennis racket, and the tennis shoes. So 你得买网球拍,网球鞋。 然后高文中觉得他们太贵了。Previously, we learned day as an auxiliary verb, which means you're going to use day to indicating the modification relationship between a complement after the verb and the verb itself, and it's usually used after verb. For example, 他跑步跑得很快。So here, 的 is used after 跑, and it's connecting 很快 and 跑 to show that she runs fast. Another word here we have is 极了 means extremely. It is usually used after adjective, so it's a degree adverb used after adjective. So it's a little bit different from 很 and 非常, which is used in front of the adjective. 这里有一只小猫,一只小狗. 所以我们可以说小猫小狗可爱极了。They're extremely cute. Or when you're hungry, you can say 我饿极了, I'm extremely hungry. 所以他们没有去打网球,那王鹏想,我们去打篮球吧。王鹏说,找几个人打篮球吧,买个篮球很便宜。高文中说什么呢?他说,每次都得打电话约人,麻烦死了。OK, so his excuse was every time we have to call someone and make an appointment, ask them to play with us. So it's too much work, too troublesome. 我们看一下里面的一些生词。 第一个是便宜。便宜 is pretty straightforward, so which is cheap. Okay, if you see something that is cheap, 太便宜了,快点买,太便宜了。 But there's a Chinese saying which goes like this, 便宜没好货, which literally means cheap price doesn't guarantee you good quality stuff. So what do you think? Do you think that is true? Or can you find some really good quality items for really low price? Where can you find them? Leave a comment, let me know. 还有一个生词是麻烦。 So 麻烦 can be used as an adjective. So you can say, 你觉得什么很麻烦? 我觉得邱老师觉得吃饭很麻烦。你每天要吃三次饭,每次吃饭要花很多时间,所以吃饭很麻烦。 So I've heard there's a company called Soylent. They provide drinks as a meal substitute. I really want to try that out. Should I? What do you guys think? Would you drink those meal substitutes? 麻烦 can also be used as a verb, which means to trouble someone to do something. This is a very useful sentence. 麻烦你让一下, which literally just means, excuse me, when you're passing through. 麻烦你让一下. So you're troubling other people to move out of the way. 还有一个生词是死了。所以死了和我们刚才讲的极了, it's pretty similar. It can mean literally to die. 有一次邱老师游泳差点淹死了。 So I've told you guys before that I don't know how to swim, and I tried to learn. And what happened was that I almost got drowned when I was trying to practice on my own. Luckily, there was a lifeguard there who saved my life. So thanks to the lifeguard, Otherwise, I wouldn't be here making this video. But most of the time, we're going to be using "死了" as a its figurative meaning, not literally die, but extremely. So it's similar to "急了." 高文冲觉得找人打篮球麻烦死了. 找人打篮球麻烦死了. So extremely troublesome. And similarly, you can also say 我饿死了. And usually, that doesn't literally mean that I starve to death. It should be something like I'm extremely hungry. 我饿死了. 所以呢, 王鹏想我们不能打篮球，不能打网球，还有一个办法是什么呢？ 我们去游泳吧，游泳。 王鹏说，你去游泳吧，不用找人，也不用花很多钱。 什么时候去都可以。 什么时候去都可以. So, 不用找人, you don't have to get people. 不用花很多钱, you don't have to spend a lot of money. So that avoided all the complaints Gao Wenzhong had about 打篮球 and 打网球. What did Gao Wenzhong say? He said, 游泳,我怕水,太危险了,淹死了,怎么办? So he's afraid of water and he thinks it's too dangerous. What if he get drowned? So here, 淹死了, this 死了 literally means to die. So this is a literal meaning here. The first word we're going to talk about quickly here is a 花. 花 here doesn't mean flower. It's used as a verb, means to spend. 我们可以说花钱,花时间, etc. It's very similar to 费, we've learned before. 我费了很多时间给你买电影票. So you can also say that as 我花了很多时间给你买电影票. And when 花 is used as a noun, just quickly remind you guys the major word for 花, which is 把,一把花, a bouquet of flower. There are other major words. This is the one that we've learned. Gao Wenzhong觉得游泳很危险,很危险. So 危险 is an adjective, which means dangerous. 邱老师觉得一边走路一边看手机很危险. 一边走路一边看手机很危险. Nowadays, everybody have a phone, and a lot of people walk around, not paying attention to the road condition, but staring on their phone. That's very dangerous, so make sure you don't do that. And 最后是淹死,淹死,淹 means to drown, 死 is to die. So 淹死 is literally to get drowned. 所以说一个人不要游泳. I've told you guys the story that I had. So don't swim by yourself. Make sure there's somebody else with you in case, you know, something happens. You can get some help. All right, so there was a lot of degree adverbs in today's lesson. Let's take a quick review together with some old ones we've learned previously. 很, very, 非常, extremely, 那么, that, 那么贵, that expensive, for example, 太 something 了, too much, 太贵了, too expensive, something 急了, extremely something, something 死了, something to death, also kind of means extremely. Alright, can you think of any other degree adverb? Leave a comment. I'm pretty sure we've learned other degree adverbs already. Leave a comment and let me know if I missed anything that we've already learned. Also, when Wang Peng was making suggestions, we have a lot of 把. Here's a quick review for using 把 at the end of the sentence to suggest something. Usually, we can say something like 我们 do whatever activity 把. 我们走吧, let's go, right? Let's go, 我们走吧. However, in English, there's a different usage for let's go. It's like a celebration when you score in the sports. So let's go. And then the closest equivalent that I can think of is 走起. So it's kind of like let's go, 走起, getting excited. All right, so that is all for today. And 邱老师觉得这些全部都是高文中的借口. And again, 借口 is like excuses. 全都是借口. 那我们今天的作业是什么呢? 我们要告诉高文中这些借口都是不对的. Okay, so we're going to do a fact check on him and tell him these are not correct and these are just your excuses. I'm going to respond to his excuses with one or two sentences and explain why they are not valid. Okay, 为什么跑步不难受? Maybe when you run more, you're going to feel better about jogging after you don't have to run too fast, right? So for the other three, please think a little bit about how you can respond to Gao Wenzhong's excuses, and maybe you can use that to persuade Gao Wenzhong to do some exercise. All right, so that is all for today. I hope this is helpful, and see you guys in the next video. 再见, bye!